Yes, that's the way it's supposed to work. VGQ means you can't say that anybody shouldn't be saying what they are saying. You just simply say what you have to say. See, that's the whole key. Let everybody talk, because people ultimately have to make up their own minds anyway, regardless of what anybody says. And it's excellent for people to hear everybody's view. Everybody's view, including white people's view, for sure, the view of white people. Anything that white people want to say about race, I mean, listen to it. Don't try to stop them from saying it. Listen to it. The key is, on the VGQ, everybody should give their point of view. You don't silence anybody. See, that's the way that happens. All right? Now, one black person will say, well, yes, what every black person should do right now to settle the race issue is go out and commit suicide. Every black person on the planet. Now, a black person can say that. But then the other black person standing next to him, if I'm standing next to him, I'll say, well, can I speak? I got a better suggestion. No. Let's get rid of the system of white supremacy and replace it with a system of justice. Don't go out and kill yourself in the next 5 minutes. Don't do that. That's what I'm saying. Now, that causes what? The black people who are listening, they have to make a decision. Now, some black person might say, well, I go with what that first guy said. I ain't going to be a part of this system, and if I ain't here, I ain't a part of the system, so I'm going to cut my throat right now. Well, the black person does that. See, we're all equal prisoners of war. All prisoners of war are equal. There's no such thing as big ones and little ones. You can't dictate to the other person. You can only give them what's on your mind, your idea about the best way to handle your prisoner situation. All right? That's what VGQ, Victims Guaranteed Qualification. Every victim, VGQ means Victims Guaranteed Qualification. Every victim of white supremacy is guaranteed the qualification to say whatever he or she chooses to say about his or her victimization. She's a victim. He's a victim. So they can say what they want to about their victimization. And to start arguing with them, it's just going to be a prison yard argument, because neither one of the persons has power over the other. It's the prison warden who has power over all of them. So it's logical. You just give your viewpoint as a fellow prisoner. So, you know, one fellow prisoner might say, I'm going for the wall today. I'm going, you know, I put some machine gun in that tower, and I know it's razor wire on top of that wall. But I'm going for the wall. I'm just going to make a break for it. In the next 5 minutes, I'm going for it. Now, the other prisoner might say, well, I'm not going to do that, and I wouldn't advise you to do that. And the other prisoner says, well, I don't care what you say. You're not my boss. So that prisoner, 5 minutes later, makes a break for the wall and gets tangled up in the razor wire. The razor wire starts cutting that person to pieces, which is what razor wire does, and the machine guns open up. And the person is just torn to pieces by the razor wire and the machine gun bullets. All right? End of that story. Now, the other prisoners look at that and say, well, I think I'm going to try that too. All right? But most prisoners will look at that and say, no, I think I better think this through. I want out of here, but I don't think I'm going to follow that example. And that's the way it should work.